They killed our husband and impregnated us. Women rescued from terrorists in Nasarawa claims. Some women rescued from Darussalam terrorists in Toto local government area of Nasarawa state have narrated how kidnappers impregnated them after killing their husbands. They were rescued by the military after spending over a year with the terrorists at their camp in Toto. A report by the Nation newspaper quotes a rescued widow, Khadijat Abdullahi, as saying her husband was kidnapped and killed in Gombe, and she has been with the terrorists for 9 months, during which she was impregnated. After killing my husband, they took me to their camp and we have been there for 9 months where they impregnated me. According to her, they woke up one morning to see the terrorists engaged in a gunfight with the military, and she wasn't sure if the one claiming to be her new husband would kill or not. We only woke up last week and saw military shooting and killing them. The one who always sleep with me as my new husband, I don't know whether he was killed too. Another victim, Aisha Umar, said she was also taken to the camp in Toto and impregnated. Then Aisha gave birth a day after the raid on the camp. Recall that the military had raided the camp and destroyed a bomb-making factory. The Coordinator Defense Media Operation, Major General John Enenche, while briefing newsmen, had said several improvised explosives, 2 skews, 6 rockets, launchers, bombs, 1 bag of fertilizer, 1/2 bag of gunpowder, 10 locally made hand grenades, 1 rocket propelled grenade bomb fuse, 1 locally made rocket launcher, 2 IEDs and 13 improvised rocket bombs were discovered at the factory. We commend the troops for their efforts at checking insecurity across the country and urge that they sustain the same. Chip in your opinion and let us discuss. Thank you for listening to this news. My viewers, you can see this is what we are saying, that the federal government should intervene by listening to the Nigerian soldiers. You see, just this little opportunity given to the Nigerian soldiers, see what that has been able to make or provide. Just not quite long, the Nigerian soldiers was able to apprehend some terrorists, the hideout of some bandits. They were able to get hold of that place and apprehend some of them, and now again they have been able to get hold of some bandits again in Nasarawa as a result of the provision of some of their quests. You can see this is the reason why the Nigerian soldiers were saying that they are short of backups. They need backups, they need weapons. They cannot go to the farm empty-handed. They can't go to war empty-handed. They need backups, they need weapons. They need weapons to face these people. Without these weapons, these people will get the Nigerian soldiers cannot be able to challenge these people, because these people they are fortified with sophisticated weapons. You can imagine, supplied to them by their sponsors, who happens to be a Nigerian. It is very, very clear. Understand? So we have to be very, very careful. As Nigerians, we have to be extremely careful. As we go out, anywhere we are, anything we do, we must be careful. We must be careful, extremely careful, completely careful. Or else, because I don't trust these people. I don't trust them. You can imagine. See what they are doing to people's wives. May God help us. My viewers, your comments concerning this are very, very important. Please don't hesitate to leave those comments of yours behind. Click on the subscription button as well as bell button to get updated whenever we upload any new videos. Thank you.